We're still trying to answer the question, how easily can people access important destinations by transit? At this point, we've created a transit-enabled network dataset and tested it out by creating a service area. But we've seen that the area reachable within a given travel time changes dramatically depending on the time of day. The results can even vary minute by minute, so simply choosing some specific time of day is not sufficient for representing that general time of day. You can't just choose 8 a.m. as a reasonable estimate for morning rush hour, for example. If we want to answer our analysis question in a way that's meaningful to real people who use our transit systems in the real world, we need to figure out how to account for this time variation. In this video, we're going to talk about transit accessibility isochrones, that is, service areas representing where a traveler can get to by public transit. We're going to talk about some ways to deal with the variations in accessible area depending on the time of day by averaging the results over time. At this point, I'd like to introduce you to a set of free downloadable tools for doing advanced public transit analysis using the transit-enabled network datasets we created earlier. It's called Transit Network Analysis Tools, and you can use it in ArcGIS Pro just like you'd use any of the built-in geoprocessing toolboxes. These tools are developed by Esri, but they're not included in the core product because they're in an experimental prototype phase. We're happy to hear your feedback about the tools and welcome suggestions for how to improve them. You can get tool info, the user's guide, a link to the code in GitHub, and the download link using the URL in the slide, and also linked from the slide notes page. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Prepare Time-Lapse Polygons tool and the Create Percent Access Polygons tool. We've seen that service area can change minute by minute, and it's useful to know how the reachable areas change over some time window, like morning rush hour. You could create a service area layer, set the time, solve it, save the resulting polygon, and then repeat the process for every minute during your time window. However, this would be very inefficient and time-consuming. The Prepare Time-Lapse Polygons tool does this for you automatically. It solves the surface area incrementally over a time window and writes the resulting polygons to a single feature class with a field indicating the timestamp for the polygon. You can use the results to create a cool time-lapse video showing how the surface area evolves over the time window, or you can use the results as input to the Create Percent Access Polygons tool to produce a more analytically meaningful result. The tool even parallelizes the service areas across multiple processors on your computer to maximize efficiency. The Create Percent Access Polygons tool helps you to create typical access polygons that better represent the area reachable by transit across a time window. The tool overlays the service area polygons from multiple times of day and summarizes them in terms of the number or percentage of the input polygons that cover an area. Areas covered by a larger percentage of input polygons were reached at more start times and are consequently more frequently accessible to travelers. The tool output will show you the percentage of times any given area was reached, and you can also choose to summarize these results for different percentage thresholds. For example, you can find out what area can be reached at least 75% of start times. So this tool helps you understand not just the total area that could be reached at some point during the time window, but also a measure of how frequently different areas are reachable. It gives you a measure of the number of opportunities a traveler has to reach these areas. Like the Prepare Time-Lapse Polygon tool, this tool parallelizes the analysis across multiple processors on your computer for maximum efficiency. This tool was developed in collaboration with David Wasserman of Fair & Peers. Now I'll give you a demo of running these tools and interpreting the results. I downloaded the Transit Network Analysis Tools, and I unzipped the file, and I put it in my project folder. And you can see that here is the Transit Network Analysis Tools.pyt Python toolbox. And within it, there's four tools. And right now, we're going to talk about the Prepare Time-Lapse Polygons tool. So the tool has a whole bunch of parameters. And I've created a facility here in downtown Cincinnati, and that's what I'll be using as the input for the analysis. So I'll choose that facility. Then I need to give the output a name. And choose a network data source. So the network data source should be the public transit enabled network data set that we created earlier. And then I need to pick the travel mode that I want to use for the analysis. And we'll just pick the ordinary public transit time. And now I need to choose the cutoff times. These will be the size of the service area. So let's just do a 30-minute service area, We'll just do one. I could add more if I wanted to do multiple cutoffs, but I think I just want to do one for now. And the cutoff time units in minutes looks good. The next thing I need to choose is what my time window is. So let's say a weekday, Wednesday, ordinary Wednesday, that should be fine. Let's expand the time window to maybe 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. and call that morning rush hour. So what will happen when I run the tool is it will solve the service area for every single minute between 7 a.m. and 9 a.m. and I'll get a separate polygon showing the results for that particular start time. And the time increment is 1 minute, so it'll create one at 7 o'clock, 7:01, 7:02, etc. There's some other options here to configure various polygon settings and stuff like that. You can look at the documentation for some details about what those do, but I'll leave them as defaults for now. The other thing to note is the maximum number of parallel processes. So my computer has 8 cores. I am currently recording a video though, and that's using some considerable amount of resources, so I think I'll just bump this up to 6 and leave 2 cores free to do other stuff. And now I'll run the tool. While you're running the tool, if you want to see progress, you can click View Details and go to the Messages section, and it will print out some progress reports about how far the tool is and how long it has remaining. So you can see it says Finished Service Area Calculation, and then it has the number and the total number. So if it's a pretty long-running process, at least you get some information about how long it's going to take. All right, the tool is finished, and you can see that it's created this output polygon layer in the map. And it's kind of hard to see what's going on here because, again, there's a whole lot of polygons that are all overlapping each other. But if I open the attribute table, you can see that there's this time of day field, and it indicates the time of day, the start time that the polygon is associated with. So there's the 7 a.m. polygon, and the 7:01 polygon, 7:02 polygon, etc. And they're all overlapping one another right now. Because my data has a field representing time, I can enable time on the layer and then use the time slider to display each polygon represented with a particular timestamp in incremental order. So if I go to Properties and Time, and I can enable time by saying each feature has a single time field. And it's automatically selected my time of day field, and it's automatically calculated the extent from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m., so that's good. I can set up a predefined regular time interval of 1 minute, since we know that the data is in increments of 1 minute. Now the Time tab becomes enabled. If I go to the Time tab, I can enable time for the layer, and I can set a time span of 0 minutes so that it's showing me only one particular time of day at once. And here's the time slider. I can just click play and it will step through each 1 minute interval and show the polygon associated with that timestamp. So you can see how the reachable area can change significantly even minute by minute. There's some areas closer to the center of town and my origination point that are always accessible, but these areas out on the outlying areas are only accessible some of the time because it's heavily dependent upon the transit service available. If you want to, you can export these time steps into a video by going to the View tab and clicking the Add button in the Animation group. Then on the Animation tab, you can choose to import your time slider steps. And then you can configure a bunch of settings and you can export this to a movie file. I'm by no means an expert in animation or video production, so I'm not going to walk you through this process. You can look at the ArcGIS Pro documentation and tutorials to learn how to do this. I also think that these animations are really interesting and eye-catching, but they're not really that useful analytically. So let's move on and see how we can use the Create% Access Polygons tool to take the time-lapse polygons we created and summarize them into something that can give us some analytically meaningful information. Let's run the Create% Access Polygons tool. The input to the tool is the time-lapse polygons I created previously. And I need to specify an output. Behind the scenes, the tool takes a rasterization and sampling approach to make the large number of overlapping surface area polygons easier to work with. You can set the cell size for those rasters here. A good cell size should make sense on a pedestrian scale. If the cells are too small, they aren't physically meaningful, and the tool will take forever to run. But if they're too large, you lose a lot of detail that could be important to pedestrians. I think about 100 meters is good because it's smaller than a typical city block, but also a little bigger than an urban parcel. You can set the number of parallel processes. I'll set this to 6 again. You can optionally designate a second output feature class. This one will extract from the main output some polygons representing the entire area that's reachable at least some percentage of the total start times. When I set the output, it gives me the option to specify the thresholds I want. Let's do one for 50% and one for 75%. And let's go crazy and add one for 95%. And run the tool. Okay, the tool is finished, and here's the main output in the map. You can see that the output polygons are now arranged with a color range. The really dark green areas are the areas that were accessible most frequently across the time window, and the light pale green areas were accessible least frequently. It's a little bit hard to see with this light gray background, so let me just change the base map. So as you might expect, the areas that are close to the facility are accessible 90 to 100% of start times. But as you progress outward along the transit lines, some of these areas become accessible only 50% of times or only 10% of times. So that means that these outer areas are accessible at some point during the time window, but they're less reliably accessible. So for example, if you just miss your bus, you might not be able to get to work on time because you don't have another opportunity for quite some time. Let's take a look at the other output. That's the threshold polygons. In this feature class, we have three polygons. One represents the area reachable at least 50% of start times, one 75% of start times, and one 95% of start times. These are the percentage thresholds that we put into the tool when we ran it. Now they're overlapping, so it's a little bit hard to see. Let's set up a definition query so that we can just see one of them. Let's take a look at the 75% one. Okay, so this area covered by the polygon showing right now in the map represents the area that's reachable at least 75% of start times across our morning rush hour time window. So if you wanted, you could use this area to do some sort of analysis and declare that this is the area that you consider to be accessible from this point during morning rush hour.